You're one in a million years. This is for all the girls, boys all over the world. Whatever you've been told, you're worth more than gold. So hold your head up high. If your time shine from the inside out, it shows. You're worth more than gold. You're gold. You're worth more than gold.
Hey guys, it's Jackie. And for today's tutorial, I have another get ready with me for prom sort of thing, but this can be used for any formal or just for Halloween even if you're finding this like months from now, but it's very bronzy makeup and it has some really funky eyes and then a curly updo as you can see. So I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial and please give it a thumbs up and let's get started with the makeup.
Like in my last tutorial, I'm going to jump right into the eyes and leave my skin makeup till the end. So I've primed my lids and with my Annabelle Skinny Brow Liner, I'm defining and evening out the shape of my brows. You guys know the drill. Then the first shadow I'm using is a matte muted pink and I'm applying this to my crease and all over the lid as a base shadow. Now I'm going in with Goldmine by MAC, and I'm putting this over the first half of the lid, and I'm really going to pack this on so the color's bright. And I'm bringing the shape higher than my natural crease in a rounded shape, and following that line, I'm also bringing in amber lights to the other half of the lid. Make sure to blend these shadows together, and now I'm going in with Brown Down for MAC, and I'm creating a winged out line, which is fairly dramatic with an angled brush. From just above the crease, we are following the shadows we've already put on, right back into the wing. To tone this look down to suit you a little bit better, you can always make the wing quite a bit smaller and just put the half moon shape right into your crease rather than above it, but I'm going full on dramatic. Now blend this out a little bit and I'm adding Antiqued by MAC underneath the line just to soften it up and blend it into the other shadows. Then strengthen the line on the outer and inner crease, and in between that, keep it a little bit softer. Now this part is optional, and you will get lots of fallout, but it's a really cool texture added, so I'm taking this bronzy pigment from MAC, and on a damp brush, I am packing this onto the outer part of my lid, and just under the lash line as well. With a little bit more amber lights, I faded the gold into that bronzy pigment. Back with Antiqued and Brown Down, I'm fixing up the shape up top, and then under the bronze pigment, I'm adding a line just under it for a cool effect. Moving on to the highlight, I'm using Nylon from MAC, and I'm applying this right on my brow bone, and then I'm going to give myself a dramatic highlight in the inner corner, following the rounded shape, meeting with Brown Down right into my inner corner. Finally, line your eyes with liquid liner. I always use the Sephora brand liquid liner, but if you guys have a favorite, let me know in the comments down below. And I just start by rimming my lash line, and then I create a wing following the shape we've already done, and then I just connect it and keep going back and forth, making sure the line is smooth. We are done with the shadow, so I am going to fix up my skin now. So I've already primed my face with my Benefit Porefessional primer, and then I'm adding my CoverGirl Clean Foundation as always. I couldn't find my beauty blender, so I'm just using a Sigma 3D HD brush to apply this, which works fine, and then with a smaller brush, I'm just touching up underneath my shadow and making sure my line is still crisp. Bronze Beautiful Skin helps put this look together, so once my foundation is all done, I am adding some highlighting and concealing in areas I need it. So I started on my chin, and then I go underneath my eyes, jawline, down my nose, on my forehead a little bit, and even though this is adding more products, I keep it really light so that it doesn't appear cakey. Usually I contour with just powder, but I decided to go in with a deeper concealer and add my contour underneath my cheekbone, under my jawline a bit, and down my forehead. This is a little bit more natural looking because I just use it really softly and blend it into the other cream products. And then I also work down my nose and make sure to define the tip of my nose as well. To set all this, I'm using my Candlelight powder by Too Faced, which has a subtle gold reflect to it that really makes the skin glow. Again, I'm setting my contour with bronzer, and then I did add a little bit of an ashier shade to create that shadow for a deeper contour just underneath my, cheekbone, as well as the bridge of my nose. Moving back to the eyes, apply some mascara, and I love my Maybelline Lash Sensational. I'm not one for the chatter blinds. You've broken hearts from down to down. Finally, for lips, line them with Subculture by MAC, and I overdraw my top lip just a little bit to even out the shape of my lips a bit, and then I fade the liner in. Lastly, pop on a sparkly gloss. I love NYX lip glosses. They're just very nice on the lips. They have a nice smell and they're very thin and not sticky. So this one looks perfect. Sensational. And I'm in love with plush, beautiful lashes. So I added a pair of Lena lashes. These are called Liz and I always use my Duo Glue. For blush, I used a dusty rose shade from my BH Cosmetics cheek and eye palette. And I'm just fading this out from the contour. This is my fight song. Take back my life. By brushing your hair through and spray some heat protectant on the lengths and the ends. And I'm going with a side part to match my off-centered headpiece, but a middle part works great as well. Section off two small sections nearest to your face, and these will create soft texture around your hairstyle later. Make two more sections from your part to your neck and tie up the rest of your hair. Split the new section into three equal parts and we are going to Dutch lace braid. This means the outer strands go under the middle strand to the other side instead of over like in a regular braid, and add in a small section of hair from along your hairline before the sectioned off bit just on the one side to create the lace braid effect. Once you have braided to about down to your ear, keep lace braiding and add in hair that tapers to the back of your neck while you keep the braid tight on a diagonal, and just finish up the braid at the end and fluff it up so it looks more full and it looks like you have a lot more hair. Now just repeat the same steps onto the other side. Better not blink or you'll miss out. Oh, oh, oh. Beautiful and amazing. Like a thunder and lightning strike. You'll never know. Now that the braids are complete, make sure you gather your hair nicely into a high ponytail. With these braids, now cross them in the back to the other side of your head. And my hair is quite long, but even if it just reaches the back of your head, that's okay too. And bobby pin as you go. I'm just pinning the ends down where they will be covered with curls anyways. Now I'm using a donut, and if your hair is shorter, you might want to skip this and go straight to a curly, messy bun. But otherwise, curl your hair with a small wand. I love my bubble wand by Bellamy, and I've started around my face, teasing them up a little bit as I go. Now to the pony, same deal, just keep on curling until the whole thing is fluffy and curly. I've sprayed some texture tea spray to give my hair a little bit of grit, and this stuff smells good too, so don't put too much because it is a little bit overwhelming, but if you're not wearing perfume or anything, it is a nice way to make sure you smell good. And I'm plopping all the hair over the donut and using an elastic to tie it off. Now we have all these little ends to play with. It's honestly easier with shorter hair to do this because you don't have so much hair to work with, but just start pinning the curls back into the center of the bun and around the bun shape. There's really not a technical way to describe this technique. I'm kind of winging it here, but just pin the curls so that they flow out of the bun. This part does cover the braids that we've created more because we're putting all the curls over them, so you can choose not to have any front hair out at the beginning, but I love how the pinned curls look and it just gives it that little bit of detail when you really look at it.
You make the party with your hands in your pockets and your innocent eyes.
Thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this look. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up. I love doing prom looks or just any look that I get to do hair, makeup, and outfit and put together a whole video. Show some love so I know to keep doing them. And if you have any other requests, you can let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget to check the down bar. I always list all the songs, products used, and my social media links are down there. So follow me on Instagram and Twitter. You'll know what looks are to come like a week in advance, like some of you probably knew this was coming up. And yeah, follow me and I will see you guys in my next video.
Coming. Yeah.
Things running around in your